Hi folks, so what I want to do in this video is to introduce this term, which is levelized cost of energy, and sometimes it's also abbreviated as LCOE. And this LCOE is a very important matrix because it's often used to essentially compare the different options that you might have for energy generation. So let's say you have an option one of generating this energy using photovoltaics. You might also have an option to generate this same electricity using a nuclear power plant. Or you might have another option, which is to install a wind turbine. So often the way to essentially compare or decide between these options is using this matrix, which is LCOE. And the unit in which this LCOE is reported is actually something that we can relate to. So this LCOE is reported in the same set of units which is used for which is what we are used to for paying our electricity bill. So this LCOE is reported essentially in cents per kilowatt hour. And if we compare it, it's often compared to what you pay typically for your electricity, residential electricity rate, and that again depends upon where you live. But for example, if you live in the Bay Area and you have a PG&E supplying your electricity, so for me, when I live in Palo Alto and I pay my bills, this cost is typically 11 cents per kilowatt hour. So this LCOE is also a very subjective term, as we'll see shortly. So often while reporting these LCOE numbers, you report a range. For example, over here you see this envelope which is representing the LCOE or levelized cost of energy for photovoltaics, and this is plotted as a function of time. So we see that as time is progressing, this levelized cost of energy for solar is coming down. And for example, let's say around 2015, which is over here, this levelized cost of energy, it's reported to be between 10 and 16 cents per kilowatt hour. And another thing you can see over here that this LCOE, it depends very heavily on public policy. So this blue envelope over here, this is plotting this LCOE with the investment tax credit, and or this ITC. So this ITC over here, it stands for this investment tax credit. So currently in United States, if you buy a solar panel, you get an investment tax credit of 30%, which allows you to essentially subtract 30% of your initial investment from your tax bill. So that's a huge advantage, and it brings down this levelized cost of energy for solar to be reduced by 30%. But this investment tax credit is supposed to expire at around year 2016, and it's not clear whether it will get extended beyond that or not. But the idea behind this is that using this investment tax credit, you reduce this levelized cost of energy such that this becomes equal or less than what you conventionally pay for your electricity. So this yellow envelope over here, this plots this yellow envelope over here, this plots what you conventionally, if you what you pay as a rate of electricity for your house. And as I said, it's for a Bay Area, it's currently around 11 cents per kilowatt hour, and it rises marginally as well. So if you keep track of your electricity bill, this cost of electricity, it rises, you know, with a rate or 2 to 3%. So I still haven't defined what this LCOE means. So this LCOE, I can represent it mathematically by using this formula, where my LCOE, it represents the total lifetime cost of my photovoltaic system divided by the total energy produced by the system. So divided by the total energy produced by my system. And this life cycle for my photovoltaic system It's essentially taken to be anywhere between 20 to 30 years. So what are the different terms I can expect in this total lifetime cost? So if I think about the numerator over here, the first term that I will expect is my initial investment or my initial amount of money, the capital that I put into buying and installing this photovoltaic system. So this is the first term I expect in my numerator. Another term I can expect in my numerator is the operation and maintenance cost. So I'm representing this by O and M. So a very common maintenance cost, for example, for photovoltaic system is that there'll be dust accumulating on these photovoltaic systems. So you'll have to hire somebody to clean up or wipe these systems periodically. And that's a very, very typical maintenance cost. Then there are other terms which I can essentially subtract from this numerator. For example, this is a capital investment that I'm making into buying the solar panels, and I can essentially deduct the depreciation on that. So I can deduct the depreciation from my initial investment, and I've assumed that my system has a life cycle of 20 to 30 years, but my solar panels will still be producing, or hopefully still be producing electricity after this 20 to 30 years. So there might be a residual value. So there might be a residual value of this photovoltaic system after this period of 20 to 30 years, and I can subtract that from this as well. And again, in the denominator, I have this total energy production. So whatever is my energy produced per year, I need to take a summation of that over this life cycle as well. So now let me go ahead and express this more mathematically. And another term that I'll use is essentially this discount rate, which I'll denote by the letter D. So the discount rate, what it takes into account is that these cash flows or these maintenance costs or this depreciation, these are happening at events in the future. So for example, this I have this life cycle time of 20 to 30 years, so I'll be paying this operation and maintenance cost over this period, but I need to calculate my LCOE now, or I need to calculate this LCOE at the time I'm making the decision of putting up this power plant. So I need to take into this discount rate, which is, if you're familiar with this discounted cash flow analysis, which is used in finance. So it's essentially used to discount the future cash flows to the present value. So to express this mathematically, so in my numerator, which includes all my costs, so I have my initial investment, and then I have operation and maintenance cost, and I need to take a summation of this over the total life cycle. So a summation of this from let's say year 1 to year 20, assuming a life cycle time of 20 years, and then I'll essentially, since this is occurring over a period of 20 years, I need to discount it. So I need to discount this maintenance cost in the future using this discount rate. Similarly, this depreciation, so I can take the depreciation and I'll multiply it, the amount of depreciation I'm taking, with the tax rate, and that is essentially, I can subtract that from my initial investment, and this also might be happening over a certain period of years, so I need to discount that, and I need to take a summation. This should be I made a mistake over here, so this should be I, because I'm taking this summation with respect to I. So I need to then I can essentially take this depreciation over a certain number of years as well, let's say X, and then I have this residual cost, which is my value of my panel after I'm after their life cycle is complete. And this is also something which is taking place in the future. So I can discount that by this discount rate as well. And I can essentially take this this total number of years, which in this case is 20, to discount for that. And then my total energy production in the denominator, I can essentially take a summation of the energy production I get over this period of 20 years as well. So I can get the what is the initial energy production that I get in the first year. So initial, say, kilowatt hour, which is produced in the first year. But I'll have to take into account that my system might degrade. So I need to take into account the system degradation as well. And there might be a rate for that my system it degrades over let's say by 2% every year. And this might be especially true for thin film based solar cells, which show light induced degradation or so on. But anyway, I can essentially take this summation of these things as well. So this gives me my final formula for this levelized cost of energy. And now I can also see from this equation, how does these two equations, how does policy play a role in affecting my LCOE? So for example, I can using public policy, I can give a tax credit, which essentially subtract or makes this initial investment or reduces this initial investment. Similarly, what you can do by public policy is allow for something which is called as accelerated depreciation. So what you can say is you can take large amount of these depreciation over a short period of time. So you can, let's say, take a depreciation of 20% every year. So you can take that depreciation of 20% of your cost over 5 years. So things like that can also affect the LCOE, and the term which through which this LCOE is being affected is this, if I'm allowing for a accelerated depreciation. Another way to affect this LCOE, or not really affect this LCOE, but drive investment into solar panels, is what is called as PPAs, or purchase price agreements. So what these means is essentially you can calculate these LCOE using this model. And what I can essentially do is I can make an agreement to purchase this electricity at a price which is higher than the LCOE, and do that over a certain period of years. So this is again a very powerful purchase price agreement is again a very powerful public policy tool, which is used to drive investment in solar. And for California, you had a very strong incentive for PPAs, and that drove a lot of solar energy investment in California in the last few years.